हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द चैप्टर नंबर 2 पॉलीनोमियल, दैट इज दिस इज द लेक्चर 1। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर नाउ। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन। सो एज यू नो दैट लेसन नंबर 2 पॉलीनोमियल इन 9th स्टैंडर्ड आल्सो वाज देयर। सो इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन फ्रॉम 9th स्टैंडर्ड, सम बेसिक इंफॉर्मेशन वी विल रिकॉल। So in class 9, we have studied that if Px is the notation of denoting the polynomial, to show the polynomial we were using this Px. Px means P for polynomial, x in variable. So polynomial in the variable x. So if Px is a polynomial in x, the highest power of x in Px is called the degree of the polynomial Px. About the degree. How to determine the degree of the polynomial? So any polynomial that is given, we have to see that which term in that x has highest power. That highest power is called the degree of the polynomial. For example, here we have made a table. So polynomial, this is 8. This 8 is not having any x or y, any variable it doesn't have. So no variable, so we can consider if we put a variable here with a, we can place x raised to 0, because x raised to 0 or y raised to 0, any variable raised to 0, the value will be 1. So 8 to 1 will be 8. So as x raised to 0, we can place here with 8 or any constant, not only 8, any number is there, any real number is there, and no x is given. So we can consider x raised to 0. So x raised to 0 is the highest power in this case. So degree is 0. So this way, because of all the real numbers, if only the real numbers are given, no variables are given with that, the degree will be 0. And that type of polynomial is called constant polynomial. Polynomial type will be considered as constant polynomial. Next example is 4x plus 2. It has two terms with the variable x. And what is the power of this variable x? If no power is given, we have to consider 1. So its degree is 1, because highest power in this polynomial is 1 only. So degree is 1. And if in the polynomial degree is 1, that type of polynomial is called linear polynomial. So once again, if degree is 0, the type of polynomial is constant. If degree is 1, this linear polynomial, one of the example we have. Next example is 2y square minus 3y plus 4. This is the variable y here. We can take as variable x, y, z, or any other variable also we can use. So here the y variable is used. Here y has 1 power, here y has 2 power. So where we have highest power, here we have highest power, and highest power is 2. So its degree is 2. And if the degree is 2, the type of polynomial is called quadratic polynomial. If degree is 2, it is called quadratic polynomial. Similarly, the next example we have 5x cube minus 4x square plus x minus root 2. Here the variable is x, and highest power of x is 3 here. So this 3 will be the degree of this polynomial. And if the degree is 3, then the type of polynomial is considered as cubic polynomial. This is the recall of 9th standard only. Then also we have to write it and we have to learn it. It is very useful to us. Next, now if Px is a polynomial in x, and if k, any real number, Px is a polynomial in x and k is a real number, any real number, then the value obtained by replacing x by k, if we are replacing x by this real number k in Px, is called the value of Px at x equals to k. Then what we say, at x equal to k, the value of Px will be Pk, and is denoted by Pk. How it is worked? It works. In example, you will see the value of Px given polynomial x square minus 3x minus 4, and we want to find out the value of this px at x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 4. So this minus 1 and 4 are called k. For example, here we have to place the k. If you place minus 1, then px will be denoted as p minus 1, as here. Px is called pk when x is replaced by k. Here we are replacing x by minus 1. So px will be replaced as p minus 1. Means wherever x we have, then we have to place minus 1. So x equal to minus 1, square it as minus as a 3 as it is. X is minus 1, we have to place, and minus 4 as it is. Then minus 1 square is plus 1, minus minus plus, 3 ones are 3, and minus 4 as it is. Then 1 plus 3 is 4, and this minus 4. 4 minus 4 will be 0. So at x equals to minus 1, the polynomial's value is 0. Similarly, at x equal to 4, we will find the value. Means x equal to 4, so we will replace this x as 4. So px will be now p4. Wherever x, there we will put 4 now. So x square means 4 square minus minus 3 as 3. X is again 4 because p4, x is replaced by 4. And minus 4 as it is. Once again, 4 square is 16. Plus minus plus minus, 3 4s are 12. And minus 4 as it is. So 16 and minus 12 and minus 4, minus 16. 16 minus 16, again we are getting 0. So the value of px at x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 4, we have found and they are 0. As in above example, this is the example, the values of the polynomial px at x equal to k equal to minus 1 and 4, at minus 1 and 4, are 0. You can see on both the x equal to minus 1 and 4, the value of px we are getting 0. Therefore, k equal to minus 1 and 4, k equal to minus 1 and 4, are called 0 of the given quadratic polynomial. This is the quadratic polynomial because it has highest power 2. So, if this quadratic polynomial's zeros are minus 1 and 4, why? Because putting this value minus 1 and 4, the value of the dx is. So this example leads to one definition again. In general, what we say, a real number k is said to be a zero of the polynomial if pk equal to 0. Like this example, if k minus 1 we will put and we get p minus 1 equal to 0. If we take k equal to 4, p4 equal to 0 we are getting. So this minus 1 and minus 1 and 4 are called zero of the polynomial. So in general, putting any value k in place of x, that will be pk, and pk equals to that, if it is 0, then k is called 0 of the polynomial, that is here in general. A real number k is said to be a 0 of the polynomial if pk equals to 0. That means in place of x, if you place k, and placing k, the whole polynomial's value becomes 0, then this k is called the 0 of the given polynomial. Now, its reverse. To find the zero of the linear polynomial, how to find zero of the linear polynomial? If k is 0, if k is 0 of px equal to 2x plus 3, this is one of the example given. If k is a 0 given of px and px is 2x plus 3, if k is 0, you know that pk equal to 0. Then we can say k is 0 of the polynomial if pk equal to 0. So if k is 0 of this px 2x plus 3, then pk equal to 0 by this definition. Pk means x is replaced by k. Wherever x replaces k, so 2 into x is k plus 3 equal to 0. Because pk equal to 0, pk equal to 0. So now therefore, if that implies k equal to plus 3 will be this side minus 3. And 2 multiplied will be down. So minus 3 by 2 is k. K equal to minus 3 by 2. So this k equal to minus 3 by 2, we have got 0. How to find 0 if how to find zeros of linear polynomial if 0 is given? 0 of the polynomial is given. So k is 0. when we can say k is 0? Because on k equal to minus 3 by 2, we will get the whole value as 0. So this way we can find 0 of a linear polynomial. So therefore, k equal to minus 3 by 2 is called the 0 of the given polynomial. This way we can find the 0 of the polynomial. How to find 0 of the polynomial? 0 of the polynomial? We have to start with the polynomial equal to 0. Pk equal to 0, we have to start this way. And replace the x as k, x by k, and find the value of k. That value of k will be always 0 of the given polynomial. Like here, k equal to minus 3 by 2 we are getting, and it is the 0 of the given polynomial, as in linear polynomial, so it is linear polynomial. In general, if k is a 0 of px equal to ax plus b, as you know that this ax plus b is linear polynomial, the standard form of linear polynomial. And if this linear polynomial 0 is k, then as by this definition, k is 0 of px, so bk equal to 0, means we have to replace x by k. So ak plus b equal to 0. So k equals to plus b will be this side minus b, and upon a. A multiplied b will be upon a. So k equal to minus b upon a. So what is in general, we can say the 0 of the linear polynomial ax plus b is minus b upon a. And what this minus b upon a suggests us? This minus as minus. What is b in this expression of polynomial? B is constant. So we have written the constant term. And what is a? A is quotient of x. So therefore we have written quotient of x. So in general, if the linear polynomial we have, so what is the 0 of that linear polynomial? How to find directly? Putting minus and constant term in numerator upon quotient of x down. This is minus b upon a by notation. So this way we have recalled some 9 standard terms here, how to see the degree of the polynomial, and by the degree how to define the type of polynomial, when the k is called the value of the polynomial, here what is 0 of the polynomial, how to find 0 of the polynomial, a linear polynomial, and here what is in general the 0 of the linear polynomial ax plus b. These things we have recalled. You are also suggested to write down this all and remember it. You will learn it. It will be very useful in next coming exam and questions.